I'd like to welcome everybody to the ribbon cutting for the Lilacs Expo 74 Butterfly renovation. Thank you for joining us. My name is Jason Conley. I'm the Interim Director of Parks and Recreation for the Spokane Park Department. Some of you were here in May 2019 when we cut the ribbon after the butterfly's first renovation. And it was certainly a very sad day when the butterfly came down in the 70 mile an hour winds in the January 2021 windstorm. With that in mind, we were beyond delighted to be here today to mark the butterfly taking flight again. A light breeze, sunshine, all the great things that you think of in the fall of Spokane. Here to share a bit about the butterfly's journey from Expo 74 to today and how this butterfly will better withstand the extreme weather and other surprises that come at us from Mother Nature, we'd like to have you welcome Bob Anderson, president of our all-volunteer park board.
Thank you, Jason. Good afternoon. Welcome. And thank you for choosing to spend part of this beautiful Friday afternoon with us. October in Spokane, one of my favorite months. Trees showing off their changing fall colors, Halloween, Oktoberfest, pumpkin-flavored baked goods, beverages, and of course my favorite, ice cream. October is often a time for homecomings at our universities and high schools. Many of us have experienced homecoming events designed to bring family, friends, and community together to celebrate their shared connection. Homecoming has a simple definition: to return home. Today we are having a homecoming for one of our true Spokane treasures. Our Lilac Expo butterfly has returned home. The Lilac Butterfly's journey started in 1974, designed for Spokane's Expo 74. At that time, there were five butterflies, and they served as wayfinders and meeting points for the more than 5 million people who attended the World's Fair. As the time passed, the fabric covering these iconic butterflies wore out, and they were removed from the park. The Lilac Butterfly was restored and installed in May 2019. With its new design and improved structure, the future looked bright for our butterfly. But on January 13th, 2021, a devastating windstorm had other ideas, and the butterfly was torn from its support and lay crumpled on the ground. This would have been an easy time to give up and move on, but that is not our Spokane legacy. Today we are back with an improved butterfly that has been a labor of love for so many dedicated to once again restoring our butterfly to its rightful place at Riverfront Park's Lilac Entrance. It was suggested that I explain what's new with this version that will enable it to remain flying during the strongest winds. I wish Barry Ellison, program manager for Spokane Parks, was up here to offer that explanation. Because as a park board, we were fortunate enough to hear his butterfly progress briefings at our monthly park board meetings. He introduced some of us to new terminology, battened wings, torsion bar assembly, and a fail-safe lanyard that even if other parts failed, would keep our butterfly tethered to the post. Even more than the new terminology, he told us of the commitment of the team responsible for getting this right. Many of our contractors are members of the Spokane community and understand the importance of this butterfly as a legacy of Spokane and its commitment to hosting a World's Fair, even when so many pundits said the city was too small and shouldn't waste time and resources. Barry not only introduced new terminology and contractors, but provided a framework for trust. Trust that our improved butterfly would be flying for our Expo Plus 50 celebration starting next May and into the future. Now is the part of my narrative that I enjoy the most, because it is time to thank many of those responsible for helping make this day happen. Save the Butterfly volunteer effort, Jennifer Leinberger, who I'm sure could provide names of so many others who stood with her. Design and engineering, Kaufman Engineers. Fabrication and installation, Westland Construction. Guildworks and Hydrofab Northwest Incorporated. Funding support for design, Spokane Parks Foundation, Parks Planning Staff, and other members of our Park Board. Special thanks to our Spokane community, who in 2014 approved the Riverfront Park Bond, putting their trust in parks, Spokane leadership, and each other to get the job done right. In closing, if you have suddenly developed a desire to participate in homecoming festivities, this weekend both WSU and Whitworth are hosting their homecomings. Or perhaps you could stay at Riverfront Park and celebrate our butterflies' return home. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob. If you haven't noticed already, there's some wonderful appetizers that are beginning to circle around. Don't be bashful. Please eat them. They are being provided today in partnership with Casa Restaurant, housed right behind us in the Papillion building. And some of you may know the name of the building is French for butterfly. And now, if you didn't know that, you now all know that. We certainly love the connection with our neighbors here on the North Bank. And we want to thank Julie Norris at Casa for their delicious bites today. Quick little story. I started with the park department back at 16 years old right here at Riverfront Park. At that time, there were two butterflies, one here on North Bank and the other was about where our skate ribbon is today. And I always thought when you arrived at the park, the butterflies kind of served two purposes. They were the first thing to say, hi and welcome. And then also as you were leaving, it was the thank you and please come back again to see us. So, you know, keep that in mind as you walk in and out. I mean, Bob touched on their purpose at Expo, but I think they're still quite relevant and germane today. Next, please welcome Garrett Jones, Interim City Administrator, to share an update on the Expo 50 anniversary of the 1974 Expo. Garrett.
Well, good afternoon. I am happy to be here on this beautiful fall day in Spokane. And boy, it's been a journey to bring back this butterfly to be flying again, but my goodness, it's been worth it and it's been an important one. One of the reasons why Riverfront Park is so unique and special is how we are able to embrace and celebrate what Expo 74 gave us in this community. The pavilion is a great example of how we were able to reimagine the structure and activate the structure and really be the lantern and the gathering place of the community. Now that you see us behind us, this is the modernized butterfly to fly with more agility and withstand high winds. As you may know, the butterfly served as that meeting point, as Jason mentioned, in that entrance into Riverfront Park. This has been an iconic piece to bring back, and great timing too, as we prepare for the 50th anniversary of Expo 74. Our park and our neighborhoods will be filled with events, activations, and celebrations from May 4th, 2024 through the 4th of July weekend in 2024. Plans are well underway for the 2-month activation of our community to really celebrate where we've been, where we are today, and really where we're headed as a community, as we all do this together. We'll be able to share our Expo stories from an arts and culture point of view, from an environmental point of view, a legacy point of view, and really what makes Spokane special in our active recreation and athletics. To learn more, you can go to our website, stay up to date, and get involved. More volunteers, the better, at expo50spokane.com. And we hope this iconic butterfly, again, will be that meeting point that has flown for 50 years and will fly for the next 50 years. So thank you.
Thank you so much, Garrett. Finally, I'd like to welcome our co-presidents of the Lilac Festival Association this year. That would be Liz Hooker and Carly Courtwright. Both Liz and Carly are preparing an exciting festival season that highlights Expo Plus 50 and the anniversary, and their festival logo prominently features our beloved lilac butterfly. Welcome, Liz. Welcome, Carly.
Thank you, Jason. Established in 1938 under the Associated Garden Clubs of Spokane, the Spokane Lilac Festival is our region's longest-running community event. We'll be celebrating 86 years next year. Each year, the volunteer directors of the SLFA set out to fulfill our mission to honor our military, empower our youth, and showcase our region by bringing the Pacific Northwest to Spokane the third week of May. 50 years ago, after being told no on multiple occasions, community leaders decided to pursue an audacious goal and bring the world to our little city, leaving behind a transformative legacy and beautiful park that we now call the Jewel of Spokane, which is why myself and my co-president Carly Courtwright chose to honor those leaders in our festival theme next year. Dare to Dream is a call to action for anyone who might need the extra motivation to pursue an impossible dream. That spirit is evident in our own foundation, as well as the leaders who brought us Bloomsday, Hoop Fest, the podium, and so much more. On May 4th, 1974, at a ribbon cutting a bit larger than this one, Spokane welcomed nations from around the globe to our backyard. 1974 Lilac Princess Nancy Cole was there beside her father, King Cole, and we are honored to represent the festival beside you today as we celebrate this iconic landmark.
Lilac Festival is so excited to be here to recognize the opening of this beautiful butterfly that, as Bob and Jason mentioned, served as wayfinding points not only for Expo, but now for the park. We are honored that it is purple, which I hear used to be the Lilac Gate, so we feel that this was a good choice to represent. We are excited to incorporate it into our theme and recognize that idea of meet by the butterfly. And I hope that continues to serve, as Garrett mentioned, for the next 50 years as a place for people to come and enjoy Spokane, as well as enjoy our Spokane Lilac Festival, as Liz mentioned, the third week in May. For everybody out there that ever felt that they had a dream, we encourage you, dare to dream, shoot for the stars, and accomplish that goal. Thank you.
In conclusion, I'd like to say thank you to all of our speakers today, and I too would like to acknowledge Jennifer Leinberger of the Save the Butterflies community effort for leading the charge to bring an Expo butterfly back to the park where it belongs. Jennifer, I'd ask you, along with our other speakers today, all of our park board members in attendance, support the Parks Foundation, Kevin, I know you're here, and our elected officials on City Council, to please join us at the ribbon cutting. To do that, we need everybody to rotate about 180 degrees where the ribbon is back there. A little audience participation. Have everybody gather up there, and when we're all in place, I will lead a quick countdown to the ribbon cutting.
3, 2, 1. They just get nervous and run away. But you can, yes you can, it's Spokane. They frown in old St. Louis the moment you look like you wanted to. But you can, yes you can, it's Spokane. I gotta confess, it's a lot more or less considered coot in Duluth, but having a ball in St. Paul, I wouldn't know, I never go. In Spokane, if you are
a tourist who's new, don't be scared. They're prepared. They'll welcome you in with a grin. Don't want to boast, Spokane's the most. From San Francisco Bay, they think about it and flee away. But you can, yes you can, in Spokane. Stranger learns how to smile, 'cause you can at the fair in Spokane.